Hey guys, so I got a few DMs with a follow-up questions about my short printer maintenance video, so I figured I would make a longer one while I do a full cleaning on my own printer and explain things a bit better. I will do it on any Cubic M7 Pro, but this applies to pretty much every resin printer out there. I do this kind of cleaning roughly every 10 prints, but it really depends on your environment. Mine is pretty clean with minimal dust floating around, so I do it less frequently. So first, put your gloves on, because it's gonna get greasy. First thing you wanna do, move that build plate, because you won't be needing it. If you have a cover for a vet, well, that's perfect. I do not, so I'll just cover it with some foil to keep the dust out while I'm working on the printer. Now you can power on the printer, and in case you have a pump like this, I recommend removing it, because it will give you better access to the linear rails, and sometimes a bit of resin can drip from the pump, which is not ideal since there is no wet to catch it. Cover the LCD screen with a clean cloth, you do not want anything dripping on it. I will use two here just in case. Lower the Z-axis to the bottom and then grab some small cloth to wrap it around the bottom of the Z-axis. Some printers have a small gap there and you definitely don't want any liquid getting into the electronics. Grab another piece of cloth, I think a sleeve from old shirt is perfect for this, and tuck it behind the Z-rod to catch anything dripping down in the back. So let's start by cleaning the Z-rod. I use VD40 degreaser, and you can spray it directly on the rod or into a cloth, whichever you prefer, just make sure to wipe it down truly. If you cannot get with your hand to the backside of the Z-rod, use the cloth you placed behind it to clean the backside. Spray it with a degreaser if you didn't do that already and just rub it left and right. If you want to clean it even more detailed, use ear slaps to get to hard to reach places. This should be enough, but if you want to go extra mile, you can follow it up by wiping the whole rod with IPA. It evaporates quickly and makes sure there is no residue before we apply new grease. Now for the greasing, I use white lithium grease from VD40. But in case you can find it, another really good option is Superloop 21030 synthetic grease. Now spray the Z-rod, remove the cloth behind it, and start moving Z-axis up and down to help spread the grease evenly. Once that is done, raise the platform and repeat the same cleaning process on the lower section of the Z-rod. Next, we will clean the rails. Move the platform all the way down and place some paper towels or some old cloth underneath the rails to catch any drips. First, wipe the rails with IPA. Now apply some PTFE based lubricant. I use the one from VD40 and it works really well. But if your workspace is really dusty, I recommend using the dry version of PTFE to avoid buildup over time. To cover all the bases, if you do a bit of research online, you will see mixed opinions. Some people say use PTFE, some say avoid it. One product that keeps coming up with good reviews is a Superloop 52004 synthetic oil, which does not contain PTFE. So if you can find that one, it's a solid choice to use it for the lubricant of the rails. Personally, I have always used VD40 that I showed you, and I never had any problems. After applying lubricant, move the platform up and down a few times to spread it evenly. You can stop it then at the top, and repeat the whole process on the bottom section of the rails. Once you're done, throw away those gloves immediately. You do not want to accidentally touch with them LCD screen or the build platform. Nothing will stick to it. Yeah, ask me how I know. Before you put the vet back on, use something to clean LCD screen. You can use hand blower to remove all the particles, but what I also like to use are those little dust remove stickers that you usually get when you buy screen protector for the mobile. You can grab hundreds of them for a few bucks on Temu or Amazon. They are perfect for picking tiny particles without scratching the screen. And that's it. I'm not saying this is ultimate guide, but it's my routine and I have never had any issue with printers or print quality. So I say, do not fix what's not broken. Hope this helped, and if you have any maintenance tips, tricks, your own routines that work well for you, please drop them in the comments below so we can check them out. And see you soon in the next video. Bye!